it's not an easy journey. It's rough, it's difficult. There's loads of ups and downs.
Hello, hi everyone. Good afternoon. I am Gillette Desguerra. I'm the editor-in-chief of Metro.style and Metro Magazine, and you're on FYE channel, which stands for your entertainment. So Thursday is Metro Chats Day here on Kumu. Now we're going to be talking about our guest for tonight. So we have John Guelias. So he's not a new name in the music scene because we all heard about his amazing feat in X Factor UK in 2018, right? So do you remember that? He worked up his way to the finals where his band, his group, United Vibe, which was founded by Judge Simon Cowell, Robbie Williams, and Lee Tomlinson. So, and then, of course, as you know, part of his stint in the show that kickstarted his singing career alongside his colleagues, so Jack Tisdale, Blaise Duncan, Elliot Horn, Kieran Harrison. Also, like 2019, so pre-pandemic, so this Filipino-British musician, he bannered a performance in Hyde Park in London, and he was with Robbie Williams, right? So such an amazing rise in terms of career, and now he's with Harshier Records, and we're getting to know him a lot more here in the Philippines because he's, you know, like I mentioned, he's Filipino-British, so Philippines is actually also his home. And that's why last year he released two solo tracks as a solo singer, and that's Wonderland and Out of Love. All right. So you might have heard his song, for those of you who are watching, because we all love He's Into Her, right? And the song is Did I Let You Go? And he sang it with Vivory. So there. And recently, and of course, Let's Just Work This Time, also released earlier. But now we're going to be talking about his latest single, and that's Hardest Thing. And this is a story of letting go and leaving with a heavy heart. Hello, John. Welcome to Metro Chats.
Hi, how's it going? Thank you so much for having me.
Hello, hi. All right, so let's talk about your latest single, Hardest Thing. So this is a story of letting go and leaving with a heavy heart. So, when I listened to the song, well, I saw the lyric video as well. It's a little bittersweet, right? It felt bittersweet. But then it's also a little hopeful. So I'm curious, like, could you tell us about your process in creating the song?
You know, I think there's that bittersweet feeling because in relationships, there's times where you know you're not supposed to be together. And so you have to make that transition. You have to speak up and say what you really want. And so, yeah, for me, writing the song, it was all about a breakup. Me and this girl were together and everything was amazing. But, you know, we grew up and we changed and I realized we weren't supposed to be together. It wasn't right. So, yeah, I told her and then I wrote the song. Yeah, Hardest Thing.
All right. So that's an interesting process. So like a lot of singer-songwriters, it's linked to you as well. And at the same time, like, you know, you worked on this with Harshier. So what's that process like? Is that...
I write all my songs by myself with my friends, but we tend to record back in England. So yeah, I record most of my songs back there and then bring them to the team here in Harshier and get their opinions on the songs. And, you know, we sit down, we talk and decide which one's best. And Hardest Thing was the one that we all decided was the right fit for the next song. Yeah.
To everyone who's watching, where can they check out your song? Like, what's the best way to listen to it?
So Hardest Thing is out on all streaming platforms. You can listen to it anywhere you listen to music, but primarily, I think my favorite place is Spotify. So yeah, if you do have Spotify, then please save it. Please add it to your favorites, add it to your playlist, and yeah.
Let's, dial back a bit because last August, actually, like late August, you performed in the He's Into Her All Access concert where you sang Did I Let You Go with Vivory. So what was that experience like for you?
It was such an incredible experience. You know, like, it was in Araneta, so there's loads of fans, loads of people there, and being able to be on stage and sing in front of all these people, that's like a dream come true. But then also being alongside Vivory, who's such an amazing artist, it was such a great experience.
What was that like, going around the country? Any favorite places?
So we went specifically to Davao and we witnessed the fiesta there in Davao, the Cadayao Festival. So I got to explore, do loads of activities all around the place, and it was just amazing. So much fun and nice to get to know like that culture and experience a little bit more of Philippines. Because, you know, I'm half English, half Filipino, and I really haven't explored the Philippines as much as I'd like to.
All right. So I actually got this question from our beauty editor. So what Filipino food is your favorite so far?
So there's a lot. But I think my favorite Filipino food, like, is the best, is the best, is the ron. I just, yeah, it's masarap.
All right. Well, ketes and a lechon. So I wonder if have you tried that as well?
Yeah, sometimes.
All right. Well, I am very curious because, like, you know, being an X Factor, it really started your career. In a way, it catapulted your career, I would say. What were, you know, some of the best things that you've learned about that competition?
One of the things I learned most is you just really need to be, if you want to make it in the music industry, if you want to even be a part of it, you just have to be super versatile, super open and willing to do things. And also definitely you have to be super, super passionate about it, because it's not an easy journey. It's rough, it's difficult. There's loads of ups and downs. So if you really do want to pursue it, then you just have to absolutely love it and really, really want to do it.
That's right.
But the overall experience was just, you know, amazing. I got to meet so many incredibly talented people. It's just have an insight into what the industry is like and meet the likes of, you know, like Louis Tomlinson. So yeah, it was really, really cool.
That's right. Yes. What ultimately made you decide to pursue music? I mean, it's for a lot of musicians, it's. It's a big ask, right? Do you really devote all your time and energy on this passion that you have?
So I've always loved music from a young age, but I never pursued it because I played football and I was surrounded by like a kind of like toxic masculinity environment, I guess. Mm. So I would always hide this love and this passion for music up until I was 18 years old. And then when I left college, I was like, what am I doing? I love music. Why am I not pursuing it? So from the day I left college, I was like, okay, music is what I want to do. I'm going to do it. And then ever since then, I've just really, really devoted my whole life to it. And yeah, now it's slowly, slowly growing into something.
Yes, now it's your life, right? Do you have any advice for, aspiring singers who are also hoping to break through like you did?
Trust the process and believe in yourself, because, you know, along the way people are going to give you a million different opinions, but I think ultimately deep down you just need to remember why you started doing music, what your purpose of doing music is, and yeah, your opinion in your own stuff, in your own music, in whatever you're doing, it really, really does matter. So yeah, just believe in yourself. That's the best advice I can give.
Wow. Could you imagine, like, if you weren't in the music industry, where would you be? Would you still be an athlete, or is there any hobby that you would have pursued?
I think I would have carried on playing football, really. Yeah, I loved football so much, so I think that's definitely the route I would have gone down.
Right, but you know, of course, like, you know, there's music, and I want to understand also, like, what does music mean to you? How important is it for you to be able to express yourself this way?
I think for me, it's my life, really. Now, it's the most important thing to me, and in a way, it's like the way I express myself. So when I write a song, I'm not just writing about anything random. It always has to have meaning, and it has to have a story behind it, and not just a random story. I want it to be about something that I've been through, an experience that I've been through, whether that's a good experience or a bad experience, and then turn it into something that people can listen to. So yeah, it's just the most important thing, and it means the world to me, really.